guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are having a wonderful day. Today I want to talk about 5 beauty products that I use differently than what they were supposed to be used for. So I'm sure you guys probably have products within your collection that you do the same thing with, that you have them and they're meant to be used a certain way, but then you find an alternate use for them, or maybe you use them multiple ways. So that's what these products are for me. Some of them are I use differently completely, and some of them I use multiple ways. So let me talk to you guys about these 5 products. The first one is this giant bottle of conditioner. So this one here is a conditioner. I purchased several of these while they were on sale, and I thought they would get used up at my house, but actually they didn't. So I had them just sitting around, and I was like, what am I going to do with all this conditioner? So I've been using the conditioner to shave my legs with. It works really, really well to help to hydrate your skin. It softens your skin. It softens the hair on your legs. So I love using conditioner to shave with. My mom, I think, was the one who actually mentioned it to me to start shaving my legs with conditioner, and I was like, what? I tried it and I'm like, that's a great idea. Like, all these conditioners that I have sitting around that I have extra of, or that I don't really care for them in my hair, these were great to shave your legs with. If you've never tried it before, I highly recommend that you try it out. Use that old conditioner up, shave your legs with it, and you're going to be happy. You're going to get a 2-for-1 deal. The next thing is hand cream. So, of course, I use it as a hand cream. My hands actually get very, very dehydrated during the winter. So I always have a hand cream in my purse, or I typically always have a hand cream in my purse. If I don't, I'll show you the next thing. So I have hand cream, and sometimes I use it for another purpose. My hair during the winter time, it seems like I always get those flyaways, and it's really nice to just take a little bit of hand cream and put it onto your hands, and then you're going to help to hydrate your hands. But then also, you've got that silkiness on your hands now, that slip, and you can add a little bit to your hair, and it helps to take down the flyaways. So I use it in the bottoms of my hair. I don't use it towards the top, but I use it towards the bottom of my hair to tame the flyaways, and it works really, really well. So if you are in a pinch and you need something to help tame flyaways, take a little bit of lotion, put it on your hands, and then rub just the silkiness part. Even after you've rubbed it in, it feels a little bit slippery still. Rub that part into your hair, and it will help to tame the flyaways, and then your hair will be nice and shiny and sleek. So that's another little tip that I do. The next thing is a chapstick. So everybody probably has a chapstick in their purse. This is something that has come in handy so many times, not just for chapped lips. My knuckles during the winter time, they tend to kind of like split apart. They get so dry, they'll just split and they bleed and they get really, really sore. So what I typically I'll do with it is in the winter time when I'm out and about and I don't have a very hydrating hand cream with me, I'll take a little bit of the chapstick and rub it directly onto my knuckles where they get very, very dry, and it helps to hydrate them. And then also it helps to kind of seal any kind of moisture that you're going to get right there into it. So if you want to put a good hand cream on top or underneath and then put this on top, it'll help to seal it. This works really well for very, very dry hands, especially if you're out and about in the cold, and the cold for some reason seems to make your hands feel even worse. So this is a great little trick that I do. I don't know if you guys have ever tried this little trick before, but let me know if I'm not the only one that does that. The next thing is bronzer. So I'm sure you guys all have bronzer within your collection. I don't typically use a bronzer on the day-to-day basis. But what I do like to do with bronzer, especially like this one right here, this is the Sweetie Pie bronzer that Too Faced came out with this year. It's got a lot of peach tones to it. So what I use it for is a blush. I use this one for a blush. I've actually taken this one right here, which is the Chocolate Soleil, and I'll mix it with a blush that's too bright or whatever. So I'll take and like go in between, take a like dip my brush into the blush, and then dip my brush into the bronzer, and then put that onto my cheeks, and it helps to bronze it up a little bit and gives it more of that sun-kissed look, especially during the summer. I think it looks beautiful. So these are two little things that I typically use if I'm going to try to make my cheeks look a little bit more summery. It's not really a winter trick, but it's a good summer trick to do to your skin. So use a bronzer as a blush. It works really well. The last thing that I do that is probably not meant to be used this way is the IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Pores. You probably have seen me use this a ton of times like this. I use a damp beauty sponge into it, and I know you're not supposed to. You're supposed to use brushes. You're supposed to use the little sponge that it comes with that is not damp, of course. It's just a typical wet, dry little sponge. You're supposed to use something dry with it, but I put a damp beauty blender into it and then tap it under my eyes when I'm trying to set my under eyes. It helps to set it really well. Plus, I feel like it sinks in, not really sinks in, it just like absorbs and looks really good into your skin, so much better than if I do it dry completely. I have very, very dry skin, so if I try to put a lot of powders on, then it just tends to look cakey and creasy and makes me look like 90 years older than what I actually am. So this is how it works for me. I don't know if you guys have ever tried it like that, using your damp beauty blender into it. You're not supposed to put wet products into a dry product like this, but I've done it many, many times now, and it's not harmed it, to be honest with you. I've not seen any kind of product, anything go wrong with this product whatsoever. So I think if you are looking for something that would maybe help under your eyes and you're dry like I am, try this little trick out and see if it works for you. So those are my five beauty products that I use a little bit different than what they were supposed to be used for. I'd love to know if you have any little tips or tricks like this as well. Do you use products that differently than what they were supposed to be used for, or do you have products that you use specifically for an opposite reason? So let me know. Thank you guys so much for watching, and until next time, I'll catch you guys later.